something like 12 times 14. 12 times 14. Of course, we will rewrite that from shorthand to longhand. We will rewrite that as 10 plus 2 and 10 plus 4. Here we have over distance, up distance. Okay, we have to build a rectangle given that information. Let's build our rectangle. Notice, we have to come over one bar of 10. Let's do that. Let's come over one bar of 10. Here I will come over one bar of 10. And I'll slide this over so that's all we see is that we're over. We are over 10. But we need to come over two more units. I will do that. I will come over two more units. I have come over my over distance, 10 plus 2. I am over 10 plus 2. Now let me check and see how far I should be up. I should be up 10 plus 4. I will come up 10. I must also come up 4 more. I have come up 4 more. I am over 10 plus 2. I am up 10 plus 4. And now to complete my rectangle, I need to fill in the corner. Here, I will get out the piece to fill in the corner. Okay, notice, I built my rectangle starting with my distances over and up, dimensions, or factors. Notice, I now have multiplied because I have built a rectangle. Multiplication is building a rectangle. I was given what? I was given one name. This is one name. Dimensions or factors is one name of a rectangle. Now I want to find the other name for the rectangle, the amount. I will write down the amount. But what I can see is that my rectangle is made up of other name for the rectangle. We were given the first name, the factors. Now we must find the second name, the amount, 168. Let's do another multiplication problem. Let's do 23 times 32. 23 times 32 means we're given the factors 23 over, 32 up. We could call factors also dimensions, the dimension over, the dimension up. We could also call it distance, distance over, distance up. And here we wrote our shorthand into longhand. Now notice, it doesn't matter what grid I have as long as I examine and see, is this sufficient to come over 2 plus 3? Yes, I can come over 2 bars plus 3, no problem. Can I come up 3 and just come up anywhere? Can I come up 3 bars, 1, 2, 3 bars plus 2? Yeah, I can, no problem. I could use this grid. I could use this grid just as long as I check, and yes, I can come over. I can come over 2 bars plus 3. I can come up 3 plus 2 more. Let's build our rectangle. I need to come over, and I'll get another piece of paper. I need to come over 2 bars, first of all. So I come over 2 bars. Now that I've come over 2 bars, I still need to come over 3. I've come over 2. I must come over 3. And notice I could have come over 3 right here, but I stop and come over 3 so that I will have my color coding showing that I have come over 3 units. I've come over 3 units, and every time I come up 10, I've got 10 bars. And notice, I just grab any rectangle that's over 3. Okay, I have come over 2 plus 3. Now I must come up 3 bars of 10. I will come up 1, 2, 3 bars of 10. It's very sensorial. We can see that we're moving up 1, 2, 3 bars. Then I must move up 2 more bars of 10. Not 2 more bars of 10, I must move up 2 more units. Here we could see how much more I must move up. I must move up 2 more units. I came up 2 more units. Now I need to fill in the corner. I fill in the corner, and I multiplied. What is multiplication? Multiplication is building a rectangle. It is building a rectangle so I can find its other name. What is its other name? Let's find out. Here we have 6 units. Here I have 1, 2, 2 bars twice. I have 4 bars. Here I have 1, 2, 3 bars. 3 bars 3 times. 3 times. three bars of 10, and 100, 736. Let's do this multiplication problem. Let's do 21 times 32. We have the one name of the rectangle, over 21, up 32, over 21, up 32, and we wrote it longhand here. Up 20 plus 1, over 20 plus 1, up 30 plus 2. Okay, we need to come over. 20 plus 1. And come up 30 plus 2. Okay, let's come over 20 and before we come over the other two, let's come up 30, or our three bars of 10. Notice, we can see if we come over our first amount, 20, and stop before we go over our second amount, and come up our first amount, we can see exactly what size our first piece or grid needs to be. We could have looked at our problem and said, well, let's see, I need to be over 20 and up 30. And I could have gotten the exact piece. Let's start over again. Instead of using any grid that is large enough, let's get the exact piece that we need. We now have the piece that is over 20. Of course, we need to still come over one unit, as we see. We've got the piece that's up 30. Of course, we can see that we still need to come up 2. But we looked at our first distance over and our first distance up, and we got our first piece. Now we can extend our rectangle over one unit. I must bring the entire amount over one unit. Well, I can certainly see what piece that is. Here, I can trace my finger over one, up three bars of 10. I can visually see what it is. I come over one more unit. Now I must come up, now that I've come over 20 plus 1, 20 plus 1, and I've already come up 30. I'm already up 30, so now I must come up two more. I must come up one, two more, and I can see what that is. Up two and over two bars of 10. I can see what piece that is. Now all I have to do is fill in the corner with a little rectangle, one over two up. Now I can see that I still have, I have multiplied, by the way, I've built a rectangle. Now I want to give the rectangle its other name, amount. Notice, now that I've got four individual pieces, I can slide. I can take the bottom and shift it over, slide it over, so that the units are in one column, the tens are in another column, and the hundreds are in another column. I will also 3 times 6 squares, or 6 hundredths. I have a total, 2 units, 7 bars of 10, and 6 hundredths. I multiplied. I built a rectangle. I multiplied, I built a rectangle, so I could find that rectangle's